Hi, my name is John Arnett, and I'm a Belgian physical therapist. During my physical therapy studies, I remember learning things that I wish I had known before. And so talking about breathing today, I'd like to present a basic A to Z of what I wish everyone knew. I'll try and make it quite interactive, and I hope you enjoy. So this is more of a practical A to Z on breathing, not so much talking about alveoli and the way that oxygen diffuses into the blood, thanks to the lungs, but more of the what we can practically know about breathing and apply that to our daily lives. So before we get started, I like to take note of how my body is doing. And so I'm going to invite you to take 5 deep breaths and to listen to how your body is doing and take note of how you feel right now. Awesome. So the first thing I want to talk about is the natural resting place of the lungs. By themselves, the lungs like to be crumpled up with no air in them. They like to close up on themselves. And so our body has to actively use different muscles and energy to open and pull open the lungs. This is why inspiration has to be active. Every time we expand the lung, we're creating a negative pressure gradient with the air outside. So as we create that pressure gradient, air then flows into our lungs. Why don't we try this for 5 breaths? We're gonna be consciously breathing in and then relaxing and seeing that our lungs empty of their air. Now let's talk about the different ways of breathing in. So the main inspiratory muscle is called the diaphragm. It's a huge muscle and it's all the way underneath all of the lungs. When it tightens, it pulls the lungs down, expanding them. Except when it pulls the lungs down, the stomach, the liver, and the other organs underneath don't have anywhere to go. So if we have our stomach relaxed during inspiration, if we breathe with our diaphragm, the stomach will push out. For 30 seconds, why don't we try and concentrate on breathing with our diaphragm, so letting our stomach come out. Now, before we start, a quick note on expiration. So our abs are muscles that will pull our stomach in. But by pulling the stomach in, the organs push up against the diaphragm, which then pushes up against the lungs and help them empty. So we also have muscles that help us speed up expiration, and the abs are one of them. So during these 30 seconds, we're gonna breathe in with the diaphragm, letting the stomach grow. And then if we want, we can tighten the abs, which will speed up expiration. Now we've practiced diaphragmatic breathing, let's talk about the other mode of breathing. Now we have a whole bunch of muscles that insert both on the thorax and on limbs, and so when they tighten, they can contribute to inspiration. They're not the primary inspiratory muscles, so we call them accessory inspiratory muscles. When they tighten, they tend to pull the chest up and out, and so we can concentrate on using our accessory inspiratory muscles by focusing on only breathing with the chest expanding and then retracting. So we're going to try and not move the stomach too much. And for 30 seconds, let's try and just breathe with our chest. Now that you've done some exercises controlling the diaphragm and the accessory muscles, you have more tools to control your own breath. I hope this helps. Please share this video with someone who you think would find it interesting and subscribe for more exciting videos. See you in the next one.